very aggressive today, sir. I don't know what's up with you.
Well, I suppose they're not going to need it anymore.
You are evil! My god! Alright, we're going this way. Power storage.
I'm out of here! Can't take it!
Yep, okay. There was two people. Would the other one get smashed into pieces? I'll take that. I don't even see this stuff. Set again. Conduction grid lower level. We come in peace. Obtain the conduction grid data. I guess from there. Else good? The orchid merchant. Some stutters and stuff. Oh wait. An unfortunate situation.
Technician Shibata. Currently posted to Genadai's R&D laboratory. Personal notation. I'd like to go on record about my feelings about Chief Technician Bayu.
Uh-oh.
Though most of my fellow employees feel that he's underqualified and incompetent. I feel that they are underestimating him.
What?
I've spoken to Breyson at length, and I find him actually to be a kind and endearing person. I think that living in the shadow of his brother, Administrator Benjamin Bayu, has given him a bad name, and that's a shame. From what I can gather, he was placed in his current position against his own better judgment, and asked to do the impossible. It's an unfortunate situation, but I will endeavor to get the rest of the technicians in the department to be more supportive.
So maybe he's an alright as a person, maybe, but he doesn't know what he's doing. And she didn't seem to refute that at all. So we came from here, obviously. We can go down or we can go... Oh wow. There's stuff in here. Sedative and hypercatalyst, I guess, for projects. White Neo City Poncho, I took that.
Get rid of some of that gear.
Deep mining space helmet. Anything else down here? No. What's with the pyramid with the, you know, the dollar? US dollar. I wonder if there's anyone on this level. Calibrated navigator skip pack. That's a notepad. It's just a piece of paper. Anti-personnel mag shot. Ammo cyber. Did you pick in cyberware streetwear? That's a workbench. Whoops. Stop that. Oh, is that thing gonna be a problem? Red Harvest wheat. I'm hoping maybe the people in this level, you know, can be separate. They won't attack us. Because they won't know what happened upstairs. Because it's a separate zone. That's my reasoning. My hope. So Sarah doesn't go around killing everybody. That was a good thing. Pardon me. Anything good? Anything good, y'all? Attention! It has been 34... what? Since your last... It has been 3 plus since your last. Please go clean up. Be considerate to your colleagues, something like that. But it got erased. You're gonna be the one to get killed. She's gonna kill you. Sarah is just killing everyone today. So hide your kids. Hide your wife. That's an interesting looking thing. It uses a positron battery for power. My god. So I'm just exploring this place. Really? He's out of here. Gonna punch the door. Sarah! That's where that thing went. I saw it from down below. Wow.
This is gonna end badly for you.
I'm getting, like, frame rate hits with motion blur included. Resetting. Okay. CTO Breyson. I'd love to talk to him, but I don't think I'd be able to at this point, since we've just been killing everybody. Especially Sarah. Let's see what this is. Chief Technician's Computer. Decryption routine. Warning. Encrypted data recognized. Warning. Encryption cipher required. Please obtain a Type GEC encryption cipher module from Chief Technician to utilize. Upload subsystem data input. Oops. Something removed? Warning. No valid transfer device detected. If you believe this message has been reached an error, please contact the IT department at GDY910. Oh, GDY says for Genardyne, that makes sense. And ask for the IT on-duty monitor. Today's uploads. Breyson Bayu. Description, brainstorming ideas, sketches. Karen Tomlinson. Peach cobbler recipe for Julia. Technician Carrick. Experiment A99OP results. Technician Hedlinger. Experiment D11EG results. And Ayumi Komiko for maintenance reports. Genardyne message system, inbox message from Ayumi Komiko. According to last month's budget reports, you've spent over 10,000 credits and have nothing to show at the review. This has to stop. For the last 2 years, you've been promising some kind of breakthrough, yet you have absolutely nothing to show for your supposed efforts. I've spoken to Mr. Harada, and we're both very disappointed, but willing to give you another chance. You need to bring us something tangible. From Technician Hedlinger. Breyson, we've had to pull storage cell 04 offline again for a full diagnostic. According to our figures, it's reporting only a 93% efficiency rating, which indicates that slowly but surely in a process of degradation. We must get the budget to fix these aging power cells, or in a few years' time we could be looking at a total plant shutdown. And then no one has power, that's not good. I don't know what the DDF is. From Technician Albertson. As per your request, here's a status of our currently active experiments. GDY022 failed. Total meltdown of all internal components. 031 ongoing. Recommend replacement of windmill blades due to lightning damage. 053 failed. All test subjects deceased. Order for new subjects placed. 067 failed. Hydrothermic coils overheating. Suggest total redesign. 072 failed. Project canceled due to projected costs and lack of personnel. 074 active. Setup complete. Request more time to adapt the plants to salt water. And 077 active. Setup ongoing. Should be completed within a month. Within the month. That's that one. Yeah. From Donald Laren, Laren Construction. The emergency exit from your office has been completed as per your specifications. The lift should bring you directly to the surface and can be easily accessed using the standard elevator call system. The cost has been deducted from your personal account as requested. Please let me know if you have any issues with the product. He made a secret emergency exit and did not use company funds so that people wouldn't know. Well. Isn't that a thing?
Well, guess they're gone.
He's friend now. They're friend now, yay. Staggering modified magpulse.
For God's sake, drop some of that rubbish already.
I'm gonna kill you. Can that be opened in any way? I don't know. Oh god. What's with all the skips? It's all restricted. Huh. How dare you restrict me? Restrict me. That's what I just looked at. got those board games. Just resetting again. So then, where's the emergency exit? Oh, the elevator, right. It goes up to the penthouse or to the lobby. Alright, so he can get directly to his apartment or just get to the lobby and get out whenever he wants to. Freak out again.
Oh, you made a big mistake.
Do you mind? Sarah, Jesus. I was hoping it was over. Stutters aren't over either.
Set aside anything useful and just leave the rest.
Oh, Jesus. Might as well loot who she's killing. And we gotta start that thing. Don't freak out by me. She's gonna hurt me trying to kill you.
This time.
You're dead.
Got away.
I'm out.
I'm out.
Looks like they got away. I'm not going down.
Slow motion? What? What was that? She said. God.
Let's do this.
Get down there. She got one. Start. So keep. You know why. Okay. Actually, here. Yeah. I don't have any more ammo. Conduction grid description. The conduction grid is an electromagnetic absorption system utilizing the shroud suspended above Neon as a lightning conduction array. When a lightning discharge is created between the array and the troposphere, the energy is dispersed evenly across the system's receptors. It is then transported via conductive conduits into our processing facility, where it passes through a series of polyphasic capacitors and rectifiers. This ensures that the incoming energy is equalized from its original positive and negative state. Once the energy is cleaned, it gets stored in power storage cells located in the power core of the facility. Current power core status. Genodyne power core status. Storage cell 1, green. No, 2, 3, 4 are also green, maximum capacity. Storage cell 5 is yellow, active, and storage cell 6 is orange, active. Download conduction grid plans. Okay, locate Breyson Bayu. Downloading. Plans downloading. Downloaded. Warning. Conduction grid plans are highly classified. As a safety precaution, they are encoded with 512-bit hollow matrix encryption. If decryption is required, please obtain a cipher from Chief Technician Breyson Bayu in R section. Well, that's in his office. It was not there. Is that something we have in our inventory? Maybe not. I have a lot of other stuff. I've downloaded the conduction grid data, but unfortunately it's heavily decrypted. In order to make use of the data, I'll need to acquire an encryption cipher from Breyson Bayu, Jernadine's chief technician. He's back this way, he's leading us back to his office. Okay. History is repeating itself. Oh, now he's here. Hi.
Stop! Please! Don't shoot.
Well, I'm not gonna shoot
you. If
you
want the encryption cipher, you're welcome to it. There's no need for all this violence.
Don't shoot him. How did you know I was here for the encryption cipher? I was wondering that.
When you accessed the computer and the power core, it sent a notification to be here.
Oh.
I knew you were coming. I just didn't know when.
Soonish. there has to be a catch, though.
No. No catch. I'm not trying to trick you. You want the cipher? It's yours. At this point, I'd do anything to get back at my brother. He deserves everything he's got coming to him.
Oh, I know his brother is, Benjamin, but... I'll ask him anyway, I'll play stupid. Who's your brother?
You're kidding, right? My brother is Benjamin Bayu. One and only. He's the administrator of Neon. And the reason I'm so damn miserable.
Oh. Well, I'm sure you have good reason to hate your brother.
Oh, don't patronize me. I know I'm no prize winner myself. But at least I don't spend my days trying to screw everyone over. You know, I've spent my entire life living in Ben's shadow. Everything always works out for him. While I've been bouncing from one job to the next, barely keeping afloat. And all the while, he laughs at me behind my back. Thinks it's hilarious to make fun of his stupid brother. Like I wouldn't eventually find out.
Tyrants like your brother eventually fall. It's inevitable. Perhaps you should just give it some time.
Take him out. How do you know he talks about you behind your back?
One advantage to being perceived as stupid is that no one takes you seriously. When I walk into a party, I'm instantly the resident social pariah. But my eyes and ears are wide open. I can't tell you the number of times I've overheard that my brother has spread amusing anecdotes about his stupid brother.
Wow. You should expose Benjamin for everything shady he's done.
That wouldn't do any good. For every scheme he's gotten himself into, he has a bulletproof exit strategy. Man's virtually immortal.
Ugh, that's true. He's a slippery man who can worm his way out of any legal situation.
You know what? I am sick to death of being pushed around. It's my turn to take control for once.
Yeah, get him.
The passcode for my terminal is GEN-41A18. That should give you access to the cipher and whatever else you need. I'm getting out of here while I still can. After you're done, I suggest you do the same.
Yeah, I think we've explored the whole place. I think so, anyway. Why are you and Benjamin at such odds with each other?
Because he's a two-faced son of a bitch, that's why.
Good reason.
It's not like I should be surprised. When we were younger, we never got along very well. I mean, he's 11 years older than I am. We had two different mothers. Might as well have been from two separate families.
Yeah, I'm sure your parents cared for you both the same.
Most normal families, sure. But mine was anything but normal. I never knew my actual mother. She was my father's mistress. And I was told she vanished from Neon when I was only 2 years old. Ben's mother, she didn't give a crap about me. Wouldn't even let me call her mom. I just had to call her Liliana. Can you imagine? And then there's Dad. So buried in the day-to-day operations of Neon, he didn't have time to pay attention to his bastard son.
Okay. Have you ever sought out your birth mother?
Yeah, I've tried. But I always hit a dead end. It's as though she was here one day and suddenly vanished the next. And then her existence was erased from everyone's memory. I wouldn't be at all surprised if my father had her killed to avoid public embarrassment. That's the kind of man he was.
Some of the things he's saying is, like, correctly lip-synced, for lack of a better term I can think of. Some of it's not. Some of it's just off. But then the last sentence worked. Sounds like Benjamin resents where you came from.
Yeah, maybe. Or he could just be a first-class asshole who takes after our father. Look, I appreciate what you're trying to do. And it's nice to get this off my chest, but talking about it isn't going to change a thing.
You can put your arms down.
That's why I gave you the encryption cipher. Anything I can do to stick it to Ben, that's the real therapy.
Yeah, that was way off with the lip sync. How did you end up working at Genodyne?
As usual, you can thank my dear brother for that.
Yeah, this we've heard of.
At first, he made me deputy administrator. Now I'm well, until I wouldn't cooperate with Owen Dexler and all of his thugs at Neon Security. Then he had me work with Valentina over at Xenofresh, helping with Aurora distribution. Until she pinned a credit-skimming scam on me. And now, here I am, chief technician at Genodyne. And I don't even know the first thing about electrical engineering.
How rough are things down here for you?
On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the worst, I'm at about, a negative 8. I don't have the background for this electrical engineering stuff. Chief technician? It's ridiculous. Ben stuck me down here, expecting me to work miracles. He didn't stop for even a second to think of the repercussions. That's so typical. All I need is one breakthrough. One! And I could shove this job right in his face. Damn, that would feel good.
Wow. Crimson Fleet. I'm fairly sure the conduction grid can be adapted into anti-EM weapon technology.
Holy crap. You might be right. I mean, it would take some time, but I bet I could figure it out. All this time I've been trying to develop something new, and it's been staring me in the face for years. Oh man, that is so like me. Thank you for giving me that kick in the ass I needed to get going.
No problem. Yeah. So, I don't know. He doesn't know anything about engineering. Somehow he's going to figure out how to turn it into something. Yeah, I don't know how we would do that. But, yeah.
Thanks again for the talk. It really helped. I have a bit of time before I leave. What is it? Feels good to be in control for a change.
As you're standing there with your hands up. Whoa. Okay, so let's reset. Actually, let's save. And that would be save. It's not... It changed my autosave key or something? Wait, now it says quick saving. And then reset, yeah. Okay. Now applying 512-bit holomatrix decryption scheme to data. Decryption complete. So this is going to be the same. Just wanted to make sure there wasn't something else that we could read, because now we can decrypt things. Okay.
You're carrying too many odds and ends. Time to let something go.
Not done with me yet, huh? Do me a favor and don't tell my brother we talked. He, wouldn't like it.
Nah. Sure he wouldn't. I've decrypted the conduction grid data and uploaded Estelle Vincent's virus to Generdyne's mainframe. Oh, I didn't know I did that part. I should now meet Estelle Vincent at the Astral Lounge. Well, I have to get out of here to do that. Oh, we still can't. Oh, we can get to the lobby then. Interesting, coming out this way. That's convenient. Oh wait, we're supposed to go in there. Oh wow. Discovered.
Kept you. I believe we have a lot to discuss.
What happened to what's her name?
It's obvious you're here to meet someone. Fortunately for them, they rented this VIP room under a false name.
Oh, brother.
I assume that same someone provided you with that clever little virus you installed into Generdyne's systems.
No.